Welcome back to CS107. We're going to start off with a bit of a review. In class 3, we covered the concept of events, the idea of event-based programming. We built two apps, the Four Corners app and I Have a Dream. So to review some concepts, an event, it's an action that causes something to happen with an app. That's a user-generated action, so it could be clicking a button or scrolling or shaking the screen or getting the text messages or such things. And then sort of a related idea is the idea of an event handler, which is very simply the event in the response. So it's the event, whatever the user does to trigger a response. So we have an example here with a button that's clicked, and the response is that the sound player plays a sound and vibrates. And another basic example here, we have the event, which is a button one, and when it's clicked, the text-to-speech plays. The response is the text-to-speech playing. The event plus the response is the event handler. So when we're doing our coding going forward, the way I want you to think about it is, what is the algorithm for the event handler? So what is the event that's being triggered, and what is the response related to it? The first thing we're going to do tonight is I'm going to introduce you this concept. It's called refactoring. And so refactoring is when you restructure So refactoring is the process of reorganizing or rewriting the code to make it more efficient. Basically, it's making the code simpler. So I have an example from someone else's soundboard app, their creative app, and the red circles are not quite in the right place, but we have four events there. And what I have covered up, or what I shouldn't have covered up, is there are four different sound players here. So if we wanted to refactor this to make the code simpler, we could do it using just one sound component. So there's an additional piece of code. It's the set sound one source, and so we might set it to, well, a different MP3. We can do it using only one component, and that's considered a much cleaner way of coding. And even though, like, this is really basic coding, and it doesn't make a huge difference now, getting comfortable and like thinking about coding this way to make it more efficient will make a big difference later. So, factor challenges is two parts to this. One is that there's a handout that you'll make a copy of, or you can use this bit.ly right here. I'll put it up in my, just enter the URL there. So you'll make a copy of this. You do not need to turn this in, but it just sort of helps you. I think it's helpful just to kind of walk through it that way. And then the second thing is I've got a version of I Have a Dream for you to refactor. So we're going to make the code more efficient. And so this is separate from the I Have a Dream that you built. And so you can get to it through the bit.ly. I've got it open here. Or I thought I had it open there. I will try this again. So I'm going to walk you through this because I think it'll just be simpler this way. But I want to, I need to actually make it. Well, anyway, for you, it'll make a copy. For me, I want to do a little editing. But we'll just see what it comes of it. So we have the user design, the user interface here, which is fine. But I want you to, you're going to do some recoding here. So we're starting here on the handout. There's an example of refactoring. So it went from four sound players to one sound player plus this extra code that changes the source. And we're going to write out the pseudocode for each event handler. And then opening the template is another way to get there. And then we're going to refactor it. So it's just one sound component. So if we were going to refactor it, it would be when the MLK button is touched down. Remember, what's this code say? It says set the sound source. So set sound one source to MLK.mp3. And then we want it to play. So it'll be sound one play. And then actually, we don't need to do anything here to this one because it just would be sound one pause or stop, depending on which one you want to do. And then when the Malcolm button is pressed, what you want is, make this a little quicker here. We want to sense, make this the Malcolm x.mp3 sound one play. And then we will need to do a little extra coding down here on the Malcolm x button up. So remember, this says 2 right now in the code. We'll need to change it to 1. So if we're over here, go into the sound 1, we'll grab the source, set it to MLK. That one is good to go. Here we need to go sound one source. And we need this to go to Malcolm. And then we need to make sure we're only using one sound player. This is the point of refactoring. We want to be able to use, have one sound player do a variety of things. And then over here, we're not going to use sound two anymore. So we're switching that to sound one. So that's a refactor challenge. We did this in class. It was really kind of a simple thing, and I walked everyone through it. That was the first thing we did in class. And then the next thing you should do is go onto Canvas, and you should check out the Creative Soundboard apps. You can get an idea of what other people have done. There's a bunch of links there. You can spend as much time on it as you want. Some really cool apps here, including the Jay-Z Listing Monsters app and the Warrior Starting Lineup Soundboard app. But you don't need to write anything. Just check them out, play them. And then you'll go on to designing your own app.
Alrighty. So this week, you are going to take everything that you learned in the first 2 weeks about building apps, and you're going to apply it to your own creative app. And the way you're going to do that is, you're going to build an app, and it's going to use, obviously, events, some of the events that you're familiar with. You're going to build your own. I guess we can watch Mr. Lieberman here. Here's an example of what it would look like.
Hi, everybody. In this unit, you're going to get the chance to build your very own soundboard app. Now, what's a soundboard app? A soundboard app is an app that has a bunch of buttons on the screen, and when you tap on them, they'll make a certain sound. Here's an example using Daft Punk. Make it, do it, make sense, honor, better, faster, stronger. And it's going to have a switch on it in case people around you don't want to hear what you're doing to lower the volume. So here's what it would sound like. Make it, do it,
make sense, honor. I'm going to stop him right there because you're not going to need the switch, but you are going to build a basic soundboard app where if you press a button, it will make, it'll play a speech or make a sound of some sort. All right, let's, hopefully I didn't mess this up too badly. Okay, so you're going to build a soundboard app, and very specifically, you will not need a volume switch. That was superfluous. Okay, so what will you need to build into the Creative Soundboard app? You need a minimum of 3 buttons. You need 3 images of 3 things you might press to make a sound. You need 3 separate sounds. You'll need 3 labels to label the sound, and the sound should play when you click the button. So a very basic example, in this Creative Soundboard app, it's an animal sounds app. So we have a seal. So if you click the seal would make a seal sound. Peacock would make, I don't know what a peacock sounds like. Probably makes an interesting sound. And you have a mosquito, and what are the things here? So we have components that you'll be using that you probably are familiar with. We have the image and button. We have rows and columns, we have a label, and we have the sound player. So all things that you're familiar with that you did in I Have a Dream, you'll use those concepts to build your own Creative Soundboard app. So this is where it's going to go. I've got a handout for you, and I want you to spend a little time with it. And that's because I think that it's really valuable, even though we're making kind of a basic app here, the idea of planning out an app in advance. So before you jump into the actual coding, to have like sort of a plan of what you're going to code. So You'll get this project handout. It's on Canvas. It'll make your own copy. You should brainstorm some ideas for your app. I think generally it's very useful to sketch a user interface, but given that this is fully online and it's just the doesn't really facilitate doing that, which is fine if you want to sketch it out on some other paper, but I'm making that optional. You're gonna have to find and sort of modify some media so that it'll can go in. Into your app, you'll plan out your code, and you'll create a new. The next step would be to create a new project in Thunkable. You'll upload your media. You'll submit the URL from this particular handout for credit, because I do want you to think about it a little bit and go through it. It sort of leads, sort of related ideas, the importance of design. So, in particular, when you're doing coding, you it's very valuable to design it in advance, so you get a chance to, before you're sort of stuck in that mode of like, oh, can I make this work? And what, you know, making sure that everything looks and works perfectly. If you can take a step back and plan it out a bit, it's going to be really helpful in actually like executing the building of your app. So as I mentioned, it's like very common, especially in app development, that you should sketch out each sort of screen in your app. In this case, your not going to have to do that, but it's not a bad idea if you want to do it for your own. You're going to find some media, and I want to emphasize, I feel like it's important as a college professor to emphasize, what we really want is media that's like creative common media. And what that means is it's already been approved for like use by anybody. So obviously we've all had moments of like screenshotting something or downloading an image off the internet that wasn't Creative Commons and probably using it. It definitely happens, but I think that it is best for this class and these assignments that we put effort to finding media that is Creative Commons approved. So here are some things you can do that. So if you're ever in Google Images, you can, or if you're looking for your images, you can look under Google Images, you can go into the search tools as shown in this GIF and the usage rights, and that will allow you to search specifically for things that are meant for non-commercial reuse. So pictures of animals, for example. Obviously save the picture to your desktop, and I think something that happens is that the name of the file often is kind of funky, so I think like renaming it something really easy, because you're gonna have to retype it at some point in, well, you may or may not have to retype it into Thunkable, but on the assumption that you might, you definitely want a simple thing to retype. So find your images that are labeled for non-commercial reuse. Looking for sounds, so three places you can go: freesound.org, soundvital.com, Free Music Archive, and there's tons of free stuff. And again, I think it's useful to rename your sounds. It's also valuable generally to trim your sound files. So you probably have enough space on the, I don't know that there's a specific limit on how big you can make your apps in Thunkable, but assuming that there is some sort of limit, I would say think about bringing your sound files down to no more than 10 seconds each. If you're on a Mac, you can open media files really easily and trim them. And there's an online option, it's mp3cut.net, and I added a video for how to use that if you don't have a Mac or just for whatever reason. It's a good site to know about. Here's a concept where I'm not going to go too deep into it. It's the idea of pseudocode, and that's like another planning tool wherein you write out what you want the program to do in plain language. So instead of like math test style writing out all of the code in like some sort of text-based language, I just, it's like in natural language, just the way you normally speak. If the MLK button is pressed, then the MLK sound file should play, that kind of thing. But it helps in like organizing your thoughts and like executing code, especially when you get to the next levels of code, to like have written out some instructions on what you want to do and what you think should happen. And so related to that, we won't overly use that term pseudocode, but it is a valuable step to plan out your code. So that's sort of a funky example where someone wrote out the code in plain language. So when the start button is clicked, go to the start screen, all the things that should happen. I think it's useful to just generally write out your code. This is a very simple example of what you'll be doing, because it's pretty obvious when a button is pressed, a sound should play, but I do want to get you thinking that way. So next, you'll create a new project and upload media. It's pretty straightforward. That's what it would look like. You create a new app, give it a name, and on the app, on the component, I guess they call it an app tree, but on the component side, it's the left side of your screen, you can upload media files. So you'll do that. You'll build your app again. Minimum requirements are 3 buttons, 3 images, 3 sounds, 3 labels, and the sound should play when you click the button. And the last part is we're going to add a sort of an interactive part to our project for this week. So what we're going to do is we're going to host our apps on a just like a basic online bulletin board. It's called Padlet. So the first thing you need to do is make an account on padlet.com. You can just use your Google login or USF login. And then I suggest closing that tab. And in a new tab, there'll be a Padlet for each section. So for section 1, section 2, and so on. You'll make a post with the name of your app, and you'll link to your Creative Soundboard app project page. So got it right here is the Padlet. And so I want to make a post here. And so the reason why it's important to make an account first is because then when you post, it'll automatically put your name. And when we're grading these, and we got to make sure that everyone does it, it's going to be a lot easier if your name shows up. So that's the important part of making an account before you get started. So if I want a title, I made a Daft Punk app, and I want to go to the project page for my Creative Soundboard app. I want to get the URL up here, and I want to put it in as the link, and then it'll be posted, and then anyone who comes to this Padlet from, I guess, section 2 can just click here, and the idea being next week we're going to get to test each other's apps, even though we may be across the country from each other. We can see what each other is doing. So that's the